respected dignitaries on the dais, of the dais, ladies and gentlemen, a very warm good afternoon to one and all. First of all, I would like to express my heartfelt thanks to complete INPSC team for providing this opportunity. My presentation topic is incident management by employee participation and digitization. This is my content of presentation. We will rush through the incident management definitions. Then what is the linkage is there between incident management and process safety? Then what we have formed integrated organization structure in our refinery, Gujarat refinery, for implementing the incident management in a very effective way. And we will understand the PDF is scoring, the scoring each and every incident in terms of number, so that one can sensitize it. It is a more severe incident or less severe incident. And the very important, the key performance parameters related to this, and finally the digitization. So incident, everybody knows that any event that could have resulted into injury, property damage, environment damage, as well as the adverse community reactions. And the main objective of incident management is, first of all, is root cause elimination of all my minor and major incidents. Management of incident during its entire life cycle. We have to restore the normal service operations as quickly as possible. How fast is your emergency response system? And finally, it should have the minimum adverse impact on your business operation. This incident management process activities are like that. First of all, you have to detect and record the incident. Unless and until all my incidents get reported, it is very impossible to do the root cause analysis. So it has to be detected. Then you need to classify it by existing protocol. And then you do the thorough investigation and find out the root causes. And depending on the type of incident, you have to define the priority, whether it is in priority 1, 2, and 3, or 4. And as you can see, the significant damage, and that must be recovered immediately. It should be within 1 hour, it should be recovered. And accordingly, 2 hours for priority 2, 4 hours for priority 3, and 8 hours. So you have to be defined in your system whether it is a priority 1 incident or 4 incident. Now let's understand the iceberg. As everybody knows, we see fatalities, lost time injuries, first aid case. This is only the top of the iceberg, hardly 10%. 90% is my safety observations, which has to be tackled first. And when I see this safety observations, this unsafe acts and unsafe conditions comes into play. And this has to be tackled by using, by a very effective safety observation by leaders. And on top of the pyramid, we have an incident management and incident investigations for all my incidents, like near misses, medical treatment cases, lost work day cases, and as well, fatal. Now, before understanding the linkage between the incident management and process safety, first, let's understand the basic difference between workplace safety and process safety. When I say workplace safety, it is mostly an individual, where it may have slip, trip, falls kind of incidents. And mostly it will be related to the occupational health exposure. But when I say process safety management, it is always a materials, equipment, and procedures. Loss of primary containment, maybe in terms of material, or maybe in terms of energy. And as well, it includes the procedural part. So main objective of my process safety management is to eliminate the multiple injuries and fatalities. So what is PSM? The basic definition is application of management controls to process hazards, to identify, understood, and control the process risk so that it can be eliminated. And this is what the linkage is. The 14 elements of PSM, at the center there is a management leadership and commitment is there, and we have three sub-elements of PSM, technology, facilities, and personnel. And under the personnel, we have this incident investigation and reporting part. So Gujarat Refinery has a very dedicated PSM implementation team, and under that incident investigation has a subcommittee team. So why I have touched upon this PSM? When I see the hydrocarbon industry, the largest property loss due to the PSM incident. Let me remind you one incident, that is BP Texas Refinery in March 2005. We all know that this incident happened because the raffinate splitter tower in the ISOM unit get overfilled and discharge was not taken out. It has a vapor cloud explosion, and when incident investigation, the recommendation comes out, it is due to the faulty level gauges. And the Becker's report has pointed out there is a senior management insensitivity to safety and incident management. So this itself shows the how important it is to manage the incident as well as to have importance on process safety. This incident has claimed more than 15 deaths and over $3 billion has been lost. So when I just see the major recommendations by Becker panel for BP, out of 10 recommendations, you can find that 9 recommendations are related to process safety. So this shows the importance of process safety as well. Now, I'm trying to interlink my all process safety elements with process safety management. At the top, you will find cultural leadership and governance, and for recognizing risk, you have to use the process technology and process hazard analysis. So when you use this, then you have to clarify, you have to identify all your process safety information at one place. And by doing different techniques, you have to identify the different hazards. And you have to manage the six changes. You have to manage changes by using MOCP, MOCT, and pre-startup safety reviews. You have to manage emergencies by using a well-defined emergency response disaster management plan. You have to manage incidents by best incident reporting and management systems. You are managing people by training development, MOC personnel. Manage asset integrity by having a good standards of mechanical integrity and quality assurance standard. And last is manage operation. When you all manage SITs, you have to do continuous improvement by using audits and effective communication. And this gives feedback to our cultural leadership. So this is how my complete PSM elements are interlinked. And it's very important that all my elements work together and have integration with each other. Now, for implementation of incident management in a very effective way, what we have done is we have divided the complete refinery into 16 zones. Normally, we used to have a departmental organogram, like maybe in technical service, some operation organogram, technical service organogram. We have a safety organogram, incident management organogram, where complete refinery has been divided into 16 zones. And head of each of these zones is a head of the at least HOD level. So, and it is called as a ZIC chairman, that is Zonal Implementation Committee chairman. And on the left side, you see the IM subcommittee. We have formed a 20 people higher management, incident management subcommittee, which will be a guiding for ZIC team member. So this IM subcommittee will develop the incident management protocol. They will look into the, on bi-monthly basis, what all incident has happened, reviews that take place, keep a tab if any incident investigation gets delayed. And this incident management committee are distributed in all my 16 zones. So 16 zones, each of the subcommittee will have one member of from IM subcommittee. So this is how my horizontal communication takes place. And both this committee meet my APEX organization, which is headed by unit head on monthly basis. So if any issues, any delay is taking place, it will raise to the highest top level. So this is how we have breached the communication gap, what we have found earlier in incident investigation. Earlier, many times it was happened that incident investigation gets delayed. Maybe it has to be completed in 10 days, it got delayed to 25 days. Because of this, because of horizontal communication, vertical communication, this gap has been breached. Now, this we in the previous slide, we have understood about the management communication part, that is employee engagement part. Now let's understand how we have engaged the shop floor as well as my operator people into this incident investigation. We have involved through our SAM activity, which we call as a safety action meeting. Here the leader as well as group are a shift in charge. Leader is only a shift in charge, and a group is from the staff as well as contractor people. They discuss the incident, they discuss the brainstorm, the ideas on any one topic, and they brought out the solution by having a teamwork. And all this discussion, facts, solution recorded online. So if suppose that shift in charge gets transferred also, it can see it at what all recommendations have come out and we have to implement this in a time-bound manner. The beauty of this SAM is whatever solution you have to give, you have to do it by yourself. You should not give any kind of recommendation which is dependent on other department. So here the people start taking ownership because they feel that they are involved in giving the solution. Now, coming to the incident investigation online path flow, we have completely shifted a incident investigation system from paper to a complete paperless system. Online, on the back end, we have developed a system where initially all incident has to be reported, which we call as an initial incident report submitted. And it is open for all, from contractor to unit head can enter this IIR. So after submission of this, it will go to the HOD level. HOD level, minimum 15 to 20 years of experience. HOD has to decide whether this incident needs to be investigated or whether it can be closed by giving single line recommendation. So HOD has two options. Either he can give one single line recommendation and close that incident, or he can say, no, it should be investigated in detail. So when he say it would go for team formation, then subsequently incident gets investigated in a well-defined protocol manner, report under review, then under approval, and finally the incident get completed. So this is how the complete investigation is there in complete online portal. And when incident gets completed, the recommendation which generated, it come out in an OPL format, that is 1-point lesson format and Kaizen format. So what happened, we display it on the site. So even the person who was not involved in the incident, even my contract person, my workers can see, okay, in this unit, this incident has happened, and this is a 1-point lesson from that incident. We had defined a protocol depending on the severity of the incident, who will form the team and who shall be the team leader. As you can see, for the fatality incident, team has to be formed by ED and team leader has to be at CGM level. So depending on the severity, it has been well defined, and as well as the team has to be formed within 8 hours for any fatality type of incident and within 16 hours for all other types of incident. And this is my standard content of the investigation report. So normally what we see is when we see the different investigation report, we find a different format. Because it happens there, because there's no structured format was available. So this is my structured format. Every team, even the leader who is CGM has to follow this format, even the HOD has to follow this format. And it follows all my from summary of the incident, then chronology of incident, list of facts, then you have to do the Y tree analysis, that is root cause analysis. And the key factors has to be identified in terms of physical factor, human factor, and system factor. Systems that needs to be reinforced, maybe in terms of 14 PSM elements, which you feel because of that incident, system has to get reinforced. And finally, the recommendations, recommendation has to be given with a target date as well as the FPR. And all you have to attach this annexes, YY analysis report, drawing, sketch. So when I click on the incident on my online portal, I see all this document for any type of incident. This is my defined time limit for preparation of the report. If any incident is of fatality type of nature, it has to be completed within 3 weeks. If it type of LTI, RWC, it has to be completed within 1 week, and for all other incidents, maximum 1 week has been given for investigations. Now let's understand the PDFE scoring and classifications, that is process, distribution, fire, and environment, PDFE what we called as the scoring and classification for different incidents. This PDFE scoring is based on this 10 criteria, what we call as a scoring criteria. Depending on the incidents, what are the different hazards and materials has been involved in that incident, whether it is a flammable material, whether it is a toxic material, what is the flash point of that material, depending on that, you have to give score. Second criteria is actual size of the release of the incident. How much quantity of the material has been released, whether it's a 5 kg, 500 kg or 5,000 kg. Third, how much system inventory with the potential for release. Okay, fine, because of that incident, only 50 kg has been released. But how much is the total potential was there that it could have been released? So depending on that, you have to give score. Fourth point is degree of control the site had during the incident. Because of that incident, whatever the fuel has been leaked, all get consumed, or whether it's a catastrophic fire, or whether it is contained in the diet, depending on that, you have to give score. Involvement of the last line of defense safety device, whether your safety relief device, your PSVs, your scrubbers, your diets has worked as per design. Actual on-site impact, potential on-site impact. What impact in terms of injury, in terms of fatality it has caused to the site, and what was the potential? Actual off-site as well as the potential off-site. So what off-site means from outside the refinery, what it has caused to impact because of that incident. And finally, the 10th point is actual monetary loss in my equipment damage and lost revenue. So depending on this criteria, any process incident can have a minimum score of 10 and maximum score of 220. And for fire case, it is 15 and 180. For environment, 0 to 90. And for distribution, is 10 to 70. So by just looking at the score, my management, my senior management can decide whether in last 1 year, in last 3 years, what's the severity of process incident has happened. And whether it is in a decreasing trend, my increasing trend, then they, after then only they need to go in detail. Otherwise, they can only have a dashboard by seeing the score. Just take an example, like I have discussed the first point, hazards and material involved. If the material is very highly toxic, as defined, toxicity is defined by LC50 value. So for process, you have to give score 20. For fire, it is not applicable. For environment, it is 20, and distribution, it is not applicable. So this PDFE protocol we have developed already, and we have set in our backend of the portal. So
Mr. Jain, please wind up now.
Okay, sir.
Time.
So depending on the flammable liquids, explosive liquids. So the officer, the team which are investigating the incident only has to enter what equipment has been leaked, and accordingly the score will come automatically. If the score is 75 or more, it is a process incident. So suppose actual leak has happened, but the score comes less than 75, it is an insignificant process incident. And if the score is more than 75, it is a process incident. Now if your score touches the 135, it is a serious process incident and it has to be treated equivalent to fatality. Although fatality has not taken place, for any serious process incident, if the score is coming more than 135, it has to be treated like fatality. And all my protocol, all my investigation system will follow the system like in case of fatality. For fire, for category A fire, category B and category C. For environment, again, category A, B, and C. For distribution, again, A and B. So what, in conclusion, I want to say, when any incident investigated, finally at the conclusion, it will be like statement that this incident comes falls under serious process incident, category A fire, maybe environment B, category B environment, and category B distribution. So in a single line, any person can understand the severity of the incident. This is some automatic classification of my serious process incident. If there is an on-site fatality, multiple lost time injury, it directly goes into a serious process incident classification. Now coming to the important KPI for incident management. This 4-5 KPIs which we follow in our organization for incident management. We monitor how much number of incident happen in a month, then how much average time has taken to restore the service from the point of first call. Percentage of incident handled with an agreed response time. We have developed an exhaustive emergency response plan where we have already specified how much time can one incident has to take and whether it matches my actual figure. Number of incident has to be broken down by priority and category, and how much percentage of incident has been escalated to my level 2 and level 3 emergency. This is my detailed incident investigation KPI parameters, where we, on a dashboard, we see complete statistics, how much incident has been investigated, and even the percentage of investigation and under the incident investigation completed, number of incidents involving injury. So the incident which have involved in an injury, what are the different types, as well as the different injury nature characteristics, whether it is a burn, cut, blown, spray. So in a dashboard, we get this exhaustive incident investigation parameter, and this really helps to take a right decision in the forum, in the meeting, in which area we are lacking more, in which area we have to improve more. And this is my reinforcement system, basically a PSM systems. So which element of my PSM has contributed more in my incident investigation? And finally, my recommendation statistics, percentage of recommendations open, percentage of recommendation closed, and this has to be closed only after site verification. Here, what we have did is 2% has been involved for the site verification. So there has to be ensure that we are ensuring that it is closed sincerely. This we did digitization of all my documents. So all my documents for incident management, my presentations, training modules has been digitized. And online tracking of all my recommendations which are closed on time, you're not. And this is what? Paperless incident investigation and communication. This is a snapshot of our portal. As you can see, all ZICs. So each ZICs, we have different parameters for incident investigation. And we do have a rewarding system for best ZIC in a month. So it's a very, very competitive system for all ZIC to perform at the best. Thank you very much.